Howdy folks, Josh here with the Weekend Angler, back with another Short Tip Saturday video and our next installment in the IBC Tote Bait Tank series we've been working on. Today we're going to be putting together the main filter of this IBC Tote Bait Tank. This is going to be our last major construction project of this series. We're just about ready to put fish in this thing and start using it. So let's get started. Alright guys, if you've been following along with this series, you've seen that we've taken a basic agricultural IBC tote and changed it into a bait tank that we could use to store live bait. And this week we're going to be putting together the main filtration unit of this bait tank. Now this one is going to focus primarily on biological filtration, which as we learned in the last video, involves cultivating bacterial colonies to remove ammonia, nitrates, and nitrites from the water. Fancy term for meaning we're gonna basically make a ecosystem. And that's what this filter is really gonna let us do. And at the end, I've even got a twist to show you something extra you can do to provide a little bit more filtration. And it's gonna change the aesthetics of your bait tank and make it look kinda cool. So let's go ahead and step over to the workbench. I'll show you what we're working with today and then we'll get started on this project. And then we'll come back and take a look at the finished product. All right, for this project, you'll need one bag of red lava rock, and go ahead and get two bags of the river pebble. If you check the video description, I have a complete list of all these PVC fittings, and you're gonna need a 27-gallon tough tote container. Start out by making a mark on the narrow side of your tote, approximately 1/2 inch up from the bottom. Place your 3/4 inch bulkhead fitting against this mark, and mark the center of the fitting for the hole. Now drill a 1 5/8 inch hole at your center mark using a drill bit or a hole saw. The fitting and rubber washer will install from the outside of the tote. The hard washer and nut go inside the tote. Be aware that this particular bulkhead fitting is a left-hand thread fitting. Install the bulkhead fitting through the hole in your tote. Tighten securely. Sorry about the blurriness, evidently my camera wanted to focus on the top of the tote. Cut your 1.5 inch PVC pipe to a total length of 18 inches. Measure in and mark 3/4 inch in from each end of the pipe. Now make a mark every 1/2 inch between those two markings. Drill a 1/4 inch hole through both sides of the PVC at each mark location. Install the 3/4 inch close fit PVC riser into the 3/4 inch to 1.5 inch PVC bushing. Now use PVC cement on both surfaces and attach the coupler to the 1.5 inch PVC pipe. Install the female threaded adapter to the opposite end of the PVC pipe. Using PVC cement, install the bushing into the other side of the coupler. Install the threaded cleanout plug into the threaded end of the PVC pipe. Choose your mounting location for the 2-inch bulkhead fitting and mark the center. Make sure your 2-inch bulkhead fitting is on the correct side of your tote. Drill a 3-inch hole at the marked location and then clean away any burrs that are left over. Install the 2-inch bulkhead fitting into the tote using the same method you did with the 3/4 inch. The rubber washer goes outside, the hard washer and nut go inside. Tighten the bulkhead fitting securely.
Now rinse the tote to remove any leftover plastic shavings you might have missed. Install the water inlet into the 3/4-inch threaded bulkhead fitting. Ensure the holes are facing horizontally when you're finished tightening. Get your rock strainer. A 5-gallon bucket with holes works great for this. Place the red lava rock into the bucket and rinse thoroughly using your hose. Place the rinsed lava rock into the tote, spread evenly along the bottom. Continue adding rinsed rock into the tote until the water inlet is completely covered. Now thoroughly rinse your river pebbles using the bucket and the hose. Those rocks are dirty. Add the rinsed river pebbles to the tote directly atop the lava rock. As you can see, I had room to add one more bag of the river pebble. I'll probably do so before putting the bait tank into operation. Now spread the river pebble evenly across the tote. Coat the threads of the 3/4-inch hose barb fitting with pipe thread compound. Now install the hose barb fitting into the 3/4-inch bulkhead fitting. Tighten it securely. Place the filter into position atop the boards on the bait tank frame, with the inlet facing the pump hose and the outlet above the basin. Apply pipe joint compound to the 2-inch male adapter. Install the adapter into the outside of the 2-inch bulkhead fitting. Using PVC cement on both fittings, now attach the 45-degree street elbow to the adapter. Repeat this process to install the second 45-degree street elbow into the first. Make sure the elbow assembly faces straight down into the basin. Determine the necessary length to extend a 2-inch pipe below the top of the tank. Cut the PVC pipe at that length. I used a 45-degree cut, but a 90-degree cut is fine. Now install the 2-inch PVC pipe segment into the elbow using PVC cement. Cut the 3/4-inch bilge hose to the length necessary for installation onto the hose barb fitting. Install the hose onto the fitting and secure using a stainless steel hose clamp. Take care to avoid over-tightening. Plug in your pump, it's time to test it out. The way this filter works, the water first enters near the lava rock, where the bacterial colonies will form, and then filters up through the river pebble until it comes out the overflow. For additional filtration, consider planting aquatic plants into the river pebble. Plants thrive on the nitrates produced by fish waste.
All right, guys, well, that's going to pretty much do it for this week's video. If you have enjoyed this video, I do ask that you give it the thumbs up button. If you're checking me out for the first time, guys, I try to post a DIY video on a fishing or boating related topic every week. So if that's something you're interested in, make sure you hit that subscribe button and the little bell. That way you don't miss any videos. Guys, in the next installment, we're going to be getting this thing ready, adding some chemicals, getting the water ready, and we're going to be putting our first fish in it too. So make sure you tune in for that one. Guys, I appreciate you hanging out with me. I hope you're enjoying this series. I look forward to bringing you the next one of the series. And until then, we'll catch you out on the water.